is like this. Now I am going to discuss about wave shaping. From the name itself, we can understand it is a wave shaping. That means we are going to shape the waveform. Why we need to shape the waveform? Because we know that what are the waveforms which are available in the nature is in the form of a sine wave. So with using sine wave alone, we cannot perform all the functionalities. So we need to modify the sine waveform into pulse, step, square, like that, etc. waveforms. So this wave shaping is nothing but shaping the waveform by giving it to a circuit. And this wave shaping is divided into two types. One is linear wave shaping, and the other one is non-linear wave shaping. Okay, linear wave shaping. The name itself indicates that it is something related to linear characteristics. So we all know that we have different kinds of components. One kind of component are nothing but linear components. Other kind of components are non-linear components. Linear components are the components which exhibits linear relationship between one or two parameters. Whereas non-linear components are nothing but which exhibits non-linear relationship between one or two parameters. So in linear relationship, we will be majorly discussing about low pass filter and high pass filter. Okay, what is low pass filter? The name itself indicates again low pass filter. We know filter is nothing but which filters unwanted thing, and so that we can separate the wanted thing. Here it is low pass, means it will make the signals to pass which are having low frequencies, whereas it blocks the signals which are having high frequencies. So the low pass circuit is nothing but a combination of a simple RC. Okay, this is a simple RC network which is having a resistor and capacitor. Both are linear elements. So this comes under linear wave shaping because we are using a linear circuit, and this is the input section, whereas this is the output section. So in the input section we are giving some input. That input is characterized by different parameters like frequency, amplitude, time period, etc. So if you are giving different kinds of frequencies, what is happening for the output? That one we are going to find out now. So when we observe, the output is observed across the capacitor here. So the output voltage is nothing but the voltage across the capacitor, which is given by 1 by C integral I of t dt. And we all know that the capacitor also exhibits some kind of reactance, which is given by XC is equal to 1 by 2 pi Fc. Okay, or 1 by 2 pi F, where F is nothing but the frequency of excitation. So based upon the frequency, the reactance of the capacitor will be dependent. Based upon this one, whether this capacitor acts as open circuit or the capacitor acts as short circuit is determined. So in order to understand that one, we will look at this small table. The frequency in the initial case, if it is a low frequency, 1 by 2 pi into low value, that is assuming the low value as 0. So 1 by 0 becomes infinite. So the reactance is infinite. When the reactance is infinite, means nothing but it acts as an open circuit. So whenever you give the input, as this is open circuit, the entire input will be appeared at the output section with a significant amount of loss at the resistor. So the reactance is high. The capacitor will be open circuit, whereas the output is not equal to 0. In the second case, when the frequency is high, what happens? Let us assume that it is very high value, 1 by very large value. So the total fraction value will be very less, so the capacitance value will be 0. So I need to say the reactance of the capacitor will be 0. Whenever this is 0, means it acts as a short circuit. So the output voltage across a short circuit will be 0. So this one will be low, and this one acts as a short circuit. So the output voltage is equal to 0. From this we can clearly understand that whenever the frequency of excitation is very high, the capacitor acts as a short circuit, so the output is 0. That means it is blocking the high frequency signals, Whenever the frequency of excitation is low, the capacitor acts as open circuit and it is passing the input signal. So, based upon this operation, we can treat this particular linear circuit as low pass filter. Coming to the other kind of filter, it is high pass filter. Even this is also a simple RC circuit which is consisting of a capacitor and resistor. Here the input is applied here and output is observed across the resistor. In this case also, we will consider the same thing: frequency, reactance, capacitor and output. So whenever the frequency is low, let us assume the frequency is 0. Whenever the frequency is 0, what happens when the reactance XC is 1 by 0, so it becomes infinite or high, and the capacitance will be acting as open circuit. Whenever the capacitor acts as open circuit, what happens? There will be no input signal reaching this resistor. So the output V naught will be equal to 0. Coming to another case, when the frequency is high, the capacitance reactance will be low, and the capacitor will be acting as a short circuit, and the output voltage is not equal to 0. That means we can clearly understand that whenever the low frequency signals are applied to this particular circuit, the output is becoming 0. That means it is blocking the low frequency signals. Whenever you apply high frequency signals, means it is making the high frequency signals to pass through the output. That means it is allowing high frequency signals. So hence the name has come high pass filter. So in low pass filter, we are having low frequency signals are passed whereas high frequency signals are blocked. Coming to high pass filter, it is vice versa of low pass filter. Low frequency signals are blocked and high frequency signals are passed. Coming to low pass filter again. Low pass filter is also called as integrator. Why we are calling the low pass filter as integrator means? Because we are observing the output across voltage across capacitor. Voltage across capacitor is given by 1 by C integral I of t dt. Okay, I is nothing but V by R. Vc is equal to 1 by C integral V of t by R times dt. So you will get 1 by Rc integral times of V of t, nothing but input signal into dt. So we can clearly understand that the output voltage for a low pass filter is nothing but integration of its input signal. So the low pass filter will act as an integrator. Low pass filter will act as an integrator circuit. Coming to the high pass filter, it acts as a differentiator. Now let us see the frequency response of low pass filter for sine input. So whenever you are applying the sine input, you need to find out what is the output there. We all know that there are two kinds of gains, one is voltage gain, another one is current gain. We want to find out the current gain here. AV, nothing but voltage gain, V naught by V. V naught is nothing but the voltage across the capacitor. VA is nothing but the voltage what you are applying. So if you find out the ratio between voltage across the capacitor and voltage across, input voltage, we will be getting the voltage.